What's up, everybody? If you'd like to stay updated with my tattoos and artwork in the future, I will go ahead and hit the like and subscribe button now. If you're a tattoo artist and you're interested in hearing my tips and my review on this first time using this Rotary tattoo pen, I will stay watching right where you're at. If you're just a client or just curious to see how this cover-up I did on myself turned out and you want to skip over everything else, you can go ahead and go to the end of the video now to see photos and footage of the tattoo when it's done. Thanks for watching in advance. Pause. You're about to see me rub myself down really, really hard with a wet paper towel. But I just have to clarify that anytime I touch you all, it's with a wet paper towel. You don't know how many times I have to correct people in videos trying to tell me that I'm using a dry paper towel on people. I just had to clear that up. Carry on. The crazy part is I was so worried about that spot hurting really bad because it was right in the front of my ankle. But it really wasn't that bad at all, to be honest with you. I am done with the outline for this cover-up on myself. And I'm rubbing kind of hard to get the stencil off so I can see it clearly. So this is my first time using this style tattoo machine. I ordered the mast. It's a cheap tattoo machine, excuse me. But before I invested in the real deal or like more expensive version of this, I wanted to try this one first to see how I would like it. I did not get used to actually holding this until maybe about the last 20 minutes. This was really difficult to transition to for me, but I can see why people like it. It is more comfortable in your hand. It's just, like I said, this is my first time ever using a pen style tattoo machine, so it took me a little bit to get comfortable with working with this. But I switched over because I am a traditional coil type of artist. And recently, I guess because I've been tattooing for 11 years now, I'm starting to feel the effects of that vibration in my wrist. And I cannot have that because I do want to be tattooing for the rest of my life. So I had to make some choices. And the first transition was this. I feel like this being lighter, not a whole lot of vibration going straight up into my hand and my wrist is a benefit. The shape of it being like a pen, like I said, is more comfortable. It's just I have small ass hands, so because it's wider than what I'm used to as far as holding a tube with a regular traditional tattoo machine, that was an issue for me to try to get used to because I didn't really know like the best way to hold it. And I'm also sure working on my clients is going to be a little different. I am tattooing upside down right now, and I am tattooing myself. But with all my machines, I always do a test run on myself first before I do anything on you guys. So what I will say is I am happy with this. It works really good. Like even with my lines, some lines here and there are a little shaky because like I said, I was trying to figure out even how to hold this money. And some spots hurt worse than I expected to. But that's a whole nother story. So this is a cover up that I'm doing right here. I'm sure I'm gonna do a voiceover on this video, but this is a cover up that I'm doing right here. I've had this on me. I tattooed this cookie that's underneath of here. I tattooed on myself back in like 2012, 13, something like that when I first started working. And I don't know, it just was time for me to cover it. I have a few other pieces on this leg that I'm gonna cover up myself as well later on. But yeah, so I'm done with the outline. Now I'm about to do the shading. I wanted to do all of it tonight, color and everything. I'll see how I feel. By the time I'm done. Also, I do have quite like a bad review, I guess, in a sense for this. This came with a battery pack and I charged the battery up good, like I'm supposed to. And it was supposed to last, I believe the battery was supposed to last for me for like 5 or 6 hours, I believe is what it said. The battery lasted maybe two maybe 2 hours. If even it was that damn long. Because I know I haven't been working on this for 2 hours. So the battery did not last until... The battery did not last throughout my outline. So that's not a good thing. So I'm going to look into sending that battery back and maybe investing in another battery. Maybe like more of a pro style battery for it to be hands-free without this cord. But with the cord on, since the battery died, it's not that bad at all. And I guess I'm liking the cord better, actually, to be honest with you. I feel like it just made it a little bit more consistent, if that makes sense. With the battery pack on it, I was having to try to figure out the power voltage to use, where now that this is hooked to my actual power supply, I'm able to play with it a little bit more and get that sweet spot that I need. More so just having like a few number settings on the battery pack, if that makes sense. So whoever, you know, tattoos, you know what I'm talking about. But that's really like the only thing, bad thing I have to say about it. So I'll continue to use this. And who knows, I might be switching over to this permanently as far as using a pen style rotary machine. But again, I love coil machines because I like to be able to, you know, take them apart, or anything needs tuning or fixing, I can do it on my own. And I just love the sound of a coil machine, to be honest with you. So this is really new to me, but again, for my best interest with my my future in this career, I have to do what I have to do. So this is the change I think I'm gonna go for. So if you have any questions, you can leave them below. I am planning on doing more videos like this where if you have any questions, you can ask me, and I'll do like tutorials and things like that, because I do get a lot of questions. It's just I be so busy that it's kind of hard for me to, you know, sit down with each individual that come to me with questions. So this is a way where if you follow my page, or if you're an artist and you're watching, if you have questions, ask me. I got you. So I'm going to keep going with this cover up, and my aim is to finish it all tonight, and I'll go through, since I'm comfortable now with the machine a little bit better, I will go through at the end and clean up anything or any lines that I see need cleaning up, since now I pretty much got a grip on how to hold it. Trapped in my mirror.